back to my channel, and today I'm back with a tutorial. I'm going to be showing you how you can sublimate a mug using a convention oven, okay? So let's just jump into it and get right into supplies that you're going to need to sublimate your mug, okay? Sorry, let me just adjust myself. You're going to need a sublimation mug, okay? I ordered these from Amazon. I got 36 of them for like $40. So sublimation mugs are way cheaper than tumblers. So if you're just getting into sublimating any type of drinkware, I say start with the mug. It's the easiest and it's the cheapest as well. Next, you're gonna need some kind of heat tape. Yeah, I know how I feel about the heat tape. If you're a loyal subscriber and you've been watching all my other sublimation videos, you know how I feel about my heat protecting tape. This, excuse me, is gold, okay? Especially when sublimating. I have a oven mitt. It's heat protecting, it's rubber. So when it's time to rotate my mug or pull my mug out, I'm pulling it out without burning myself. This is key. You need this. I'm also going to be using a silicone mug wrap, okay? When we get to the part of the video, I will explain what the silicone mug wrap purpose is. And also, I'm going to be using just a piece of parchment paper that I cut from a larger piece, okay? So that's all you're going to need for sublimating a mug. So let's just get into it, okay? I forgot to mention in our supplies, the obvious, you're definitely going to need some kind of convention oven. I've seen people use a mug press. I've seen people use air fryers, but for me, I'm going to use the convention oven. And also, you're going to need some kind of oven thermometer gauge, just to gauge your time and your heat, okay? Especially heat. Heat and timing is very, very important when sublimating a mug. Okay, so now we have our mug, and this is the image that we're going to be using on the mug today. I chose this image for the video because it's so bright, it's so colorful, and then you can really see how well Cosmos inks work and how well it's going to sublimate to these mugs. And these mugs are great. I'm going to link them. I promise I'm going to link them in the description box below. I've been saying I'm going to get better at my links. I'll even link the convention oven because I got most of my things from Amazon. So I'm going to be sure to link it, everything in the description box below, okay? I promise. And I'm using A-Sub paper Cosmos ink. Okay, so next you want to get that heat tape ready because we're going to get ready and position it on the mug. So I make a lot of right mug drinker cups, if it makes sense. I like to put my image on this side, so when it's like held with the, and I feel like lefties, it should be on this side, you know what I mean? So the mug is going to be for me since I'm making it for the video purpose. And I'll show you some other mugs I did once I put this image down and how well they came out, okay? You're gonna be like, wow, okay? This Cosmos ink, it took me a while to get with the convention oven method, but I love it now. So once you just line your image up on the mug wherever you want it, okay? Just line it up precisely, because once it's down, this tape pretty much sometimes rips the paper, so just make sure you have it lined up where you want it, okay? And just cut off that. I usually have some tape pre-cut. I don't know why I didn't pre-cut the tape for the video. That would have just helped the video go right along. But it's okay. I'm just taping it down and I'm kind of moving fast with the tape, okay? So let me just get some more tape. And tape it better than this, guys. I'm not doing a good job with the tape because I'm rushing, but you want to tape it good. You want to tape it more so like this, okay? You want to tape it down. And what I usually do, I leave some up at the top, like a little tab at the top. So when you take it out the oven and you need help peeling it off, because it will be extremely hot. That's something else I'll talk to you about when we get to that stage of the mug. Pulling off that tape and that mug wrap is going to be extremely hot. So that's why it's very important to have your silicone oven mitt. Okay? Very important to do that. Now what I did wrong right here, I should have taped down the sides. first. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna leave. All right. I'm gonna take down the last side, and then I'm gonna tell you the next steps for heat and time for sublimating a mug. Okay? So heat and time. So now that you got your image taped down, I'm gonna put some additional tape across the center of it. Okay. Now that you got your image taped down on your mug exactly where you want it, go ahead and get that parchment paper that we talked about and wrap your mug, okay? Just wrap it. It's almost like another barrier to protect the cup from burning or the image from burning on the cup. And just adjust it with a piece of tape. So where's my tape at? Just adjust it with a piece of tape. That was an old piece of tape that I already had on the parchment paper that I thought was gonna work, but it fooled me. So wrap your mug with the parchment paper, okay? And then, like I said, this is a barrier, so to help protect the image from any burning while it's being pressed, okay? So it don't have to be on super tight, just enough to so it can be around the mug like so. Then you want to go ahead and get this mug press. This is the mug press for the 11-ounce cup. These cups are 11 ounces, okay? Once you have that, you just want to take your mug press. And this mug press, the purpose of this mug press is to add added pressure that pushes down on the image. And you just click it to make sure that image and that color is going into the mug, okay? So it's all ready for pressing. Now, I'm going to show you what time we're going to set our oven to and the heat, okay? So stay tuned. Let me reposition the camera for you a little better. So with this oven, I've noticed that it gets really, really hot. And I noticed that also what it reads, the temperature reads, like I put it on a little before 350. In actuality, it's almost like 400. And I learned that because I had a oven thermometer helping me gauge my temperature. But your desired heat should be anything between 385, 400 degrees. That is the desired heat to sublimate mugs and tumblers, okay? I do mine's 400 degrees for 10 minutes, sometimes 11 minutes, 12 minutes maximum if it's a wraparound image, okay? So because we're doing a mug that has a single-sided image, I'm only going to do it for 10. And what I do is I put it in there when my oven is hot. I leave it in there for 5 minutes. I set a timer. Once that 5 minutes is up, I go in with my oven mitt and I rotate the cup so that there's even amount of heat that's applying to the cup. Okay. That's all I do. And once the 10 minutes up, I pull the cup out. I take off the latch and I'm going to reveal how pretty the image sublimated to the mug. Okay. So while that's heating up, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, guys. I really appreciate all my subscribers and all the likes and all the comments. And I'm so glad that I can help so many people get into this craft life because there is a lot of money in crafts. And like I said, the holidays are coming up. Mugs are a very popular gift. Like just a small gift for neighbors, friends, teachers. And we know we appreciate our teachers because I'm a teacher too, guys. And I appreciate a good mug, okay? Get you some mugs, get you a nice little, it's not even an expensive craft to get into, okay? Like I said, I'll link all of my things below and check it out. Check it out, guys. You're not going to be disappointed. Even the oven I got from Amazon, okay? Amazon's great. All right, so I'm going to just go ahead and put my cup in there because it's heating up really fast. So I'm going to stand up. I'm gonna place it in there. Okay, be careful because it is getting hot. I'm gonna place it in there. And I'm gonna come back in 5 minutes, guys. You come back with me too. Stay tuned. Okay, guys, I know I said I wanted to show you some of my cups that I have been working on using the same ink, the same method, so you can get the same idea of what your cup is gonna look like. So our cup is still heating up. The 5 minutes has not been up. Remember, I told you, I'm going back and I've set the timer already. I'm going back in 5 minutes and I'm just going to rotate it, okay? But I wanted to show you guys while we're letting that heat up some of the cups I already did using the same method that we're doing today. Look how pretty. And this is a wraparound cup, what I was trying to explain to you guys earlier. Okay, I left this in maybe 12 minutes. That's one. A photo cup, I would also leave in for 12 minutes. Okay, look how pretty and how popping this ink is, y'all. I'm sorry, I've tried one other sublimation ink early in my sublimation journey. And once I found Cosmos Ink, I've been a loyal subscriber. I mean, loyal customer, this Cosmos Ink. All right, and this is another one that I did. Okay, and we love the message. Stay humble and hustle hard, crafters. Get this money, okay? It's a great gift. Look how pretty and professional and clean this looks, okay? I'm telling you, you're gonna wanna get into this. And this is a personal favorite of mine. Y'all know what's going on in the news with Breonna Taylor, and I just had to make me a mug. Once again, Cosmos Ink. I just had to make me a mug. This is my personal mug, and I just put Say Her Name on it. Beautiful, beautiful. Say her name. Rest in peace to this queen, okay? Rest in power. All right, let's move on because this is gonna make me emotional, y'all. Y'all don't know how upset I was. All right, so our mug is just about 5 minutes. It's just about 5 minutes on our mug. I know my timer's gonna go off any moment. So like I said, my oven gets way hotter than what it says, okay? So that's why I have it reads a lower temperature, but it heats up way hotter. And I had to learn that after I burnt like the third mug. I had to figure out what was the issue. So I turned my dial down to about 350 and noticed, okay, that's exactly what it was. Just because it's on 400, it was really the temperature inside was 450. So it was burning my mugs, okay? If that makes sense. So I know we just about ready. I'm gonna just go ahead in now and turn the mug. That's all I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna go in, be very careful. Make sure you have on your mug, your glove, because at this point, it is smoking hot in here. So I'm just gonna go in, be careful. And I'm just gonna rotate the mug. And I'm gonna pop it back in there for another 5 minutes. And then once that 5 minutes is up, the image will be ready to show, okay? So stay tuned, we're not done yet. You're sublimating the mug tonight, guys. All right, guys, we're just about ready to take this mug out the oven. Also, I wanted to go over some things that I didn't go over in the beginning. You do need a sublimation printer, sublimation ink, to do this, okay? That image that I printed out was sublimation ink and it was sublimation paper. I don't want people to get the wrong idea that you don't need those things. That is my printer that I use, which is a sublimation printer. Which is Epson 7720, okay? Like I said, the ink that I use is Cosmos Ink, and the paper that I prefer to use is Acer paper. Everything purchased on Amazon except for the ink, okay? Even the oven. All right, so let's go ahead and switch this baby off. I like to switch my devices off because we don't like fire. We don't want any accidents. And now we're gonna get ready and pull the mug out. Well, I like to let it just sit. I'm gonna just let it sit a little while longer, you know? 30 seconds longer. And while I tell you guys again to subscribe, go ahead and hit that button. I'm gonna wait. You hit it? Y'all ready? Okay, homegirl says she need more time. You got it? All right, y'all better have subscribed. Okay, let's get ready and take this bad boy out. I'm excited for you to see how well these colors pop. I'm just so excited for you to see how well the ink and this method works. Now there's so many other methods. Some people do the shrink wrap paper. Other people have the mug press. I'm using a convention oven that I paid $40 for, okay? A mug press that I found on Amazon. And you know, we're just gonna see how well it came out. Now like I said, it's gonna be extremely hot, okay? Let me just reposition the camera for you guys so you can see the big reveal. So it's gonna be extremely hot, so that explains the actual towel here, because I didn't wanna, it's gonna be extremely hot, okay? And when you can see your image through the paper, that's a good sign, okay? So when you can actually see the image through the paper, that's a good sign that you have a successful sublimation project. So that's why I left that tab. You see how easy it was for me to start peeling the tape off because of the tab that I left. So like I said, it's gonna be extremely hot. So please be careful, ladies and gents, because it will be extremely hot, okay? So just take your time. Ooh. Look at this color. Do y'all see this color? Okay, look how popping this color is. Wow. OMG, perfect timing. I have to put it down, even getting hot through the gloves. Okay, y'all, let me just bring this camera in this, cause I gotta show y'all this, okay? Look how nice this is. Okay, you wanna achieve this, just follow these simple steps. Nothing hard about this. Get you a $40 convention oven. You don't need to upgrade your convention oven until you mastered mugs, okay? And you are doing tumblers. Now for tumblers, I use a totally different oven, okay? A video coming for tumblers soon, okay? But get this, okay? Oh my God, I'm just so in love with this mug. This is definitely a personal favorite of my own. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I have. I can't wait to see some of your sublimation mug projects. The holidays are coming up. Please drop them in the comments below. Like, and don't forget to share. And like, as always, don't forget to subscribe, okay? And AP, Anna P, whatever you wanna call me. I'm the newbie for the newbies, and I got y'all. Bye.